I'm Charitha Santa, physiotherapy student, Faculty of Medicine, University of Colombo. My research topic is the prevalence of musculoskeletal injuries among the gymnasium users in the Colombo district. This study mainly focuses on the prevalence of injuries associated with the physical training among the gymnasium users in the Colombo, in the local context. In the modern world, many people willing to go to gymnasium. In the gym, they play according to schedule which was made by the physical trainer. In this topic, most of the research is done in the European countries, but we are do the same exercise, but we are different for the genetically, geographically, and the habitually. So we have to find how healthy our gymnasium methodology. This is the descriptive cross-sectional study. 300 members selected randomly from the 10 gymnasium covers all the Colombo district. Data were collected using the interview administered questionnaire, and we gather about the injured area, injured region, and the exercise protocol, and the injury time and the injury frequency. And finally, get the data about the whether the members take anabolic steroids. And then we are next move to the results. It's observed 85% of our population has any kind of injuries, and that more than 50% of injuries are chronic, and just 46.5 acute injuries reported. Only 2.5 traumatic injuries reported. But when you consider about from the other European researchers, chronic injuries are relatively low, but acute injuries are more than 50% and a significant amount of acute injuries reported. When next move to injury regions, previous literature mentions lower back is the commonly get injured area, but in here, shoulder is a commonly get injured. Also follows by the wrist, lower back, and the knee. Look at this first chart, most shoulder, lower back, and knee area associated with the chronic type injuries, and the wrist area associated with the acute type injuries. Next move to the exercise involved for injuries. And the previous researchers mentions bench press caused the most of the upper limb injuries, but that change in here, upright caused the most of the upper limb injuries. Also, previous literature mentioned deadlift and squats caused for the most of the lower limb injuries. That same in here. But next move to the relation steroid users and injury occurrence, there is a significant relationship between the steroid users and the injury occurrence. Look at this third chart. Steroid users have more injury areas. Next, we are going to exercise protocol and the injury occurrence. So there is a significant relationship between the warm-up, pre-stretching, post-stretching, cool-down, and with the injury occurrence. But numbers did warm up, pre-stretching, and the post-stretching and the cool down very low compared with the other countries. So more to the, but also there is no significant relationship between the injury time and injury frequency with injuries. Next, move to the conclusion. The above finding forces significant and unforeseen risks for the young people which are going to the gymnasium. So they are not aware of the exercise protocol correctly. Also, nowadays, steroids are popular in the Sri Lanka context. So people should aware about the exercise protocol correctly and the adverse and side effect of the steroid user. Also, chronic injuries in so higher in the Sri Lankan setting. Adequate rest should be taken to heal, especially shoulder, lower back, and knee area. They have high tendency to go towards the chronic type injuries. Also, risky exercise like upright squats and deadlift should be followed under proper supervision. Thank you, Professor.